everyone. My name's Booth Armstrong and I work for OHD, and I'm excited about providing a quick start training video for you on the OHD Quantifit respiratory mask fit testing device. Today we're going to paint with a broad stroke, but eager that this video would help you launch out in your endeavor of doing your fit testing, and I think you'll find it as a valuable resource. For an outline for today, we'll start off by connecting on what the partnership with OHD and you will be and what we're eager to provide for you as you do your fit testing. We'll go to talking about what all is in that box that you have that comes along with the Quantifit. After we talk about that, we'll connect on how to do a daily calibration to the device. After we talk about how to do a daily calibration, we'll cover the two different methods of testing, standalone testing, or managing the device via our software. After we do that, we'll kind of sink our fingers into the software, get you familiarized with that. Then we'll knock out some testing so you can see some testing in action. Then we will look at doing a troubleshooting process so you can learn a little bit on how to identify what's going on or addressing a respirator that's not passing. And then we'll put a bow on everything, just connecting it once again on our partnership and reiterating OHD's eagerness to assist in any way possible, which is a great segue to our first point. OHD is excited about a partnership with you. What does that look like? OHD is eager to provide any and all support, tech support, throughout the life of the equipment. If you need help with our software, if you need help with managing data, if you need help with troubleshooting a respirator, anything you encounter while managing your fit testing and doing your fit testing, OHD wants to be a key in that process, and we're excited about having a connected relationship where you can find all the support you need at OHD. A huge part of accessing that support and that partnership will be OHD's website, www.ohdusa.com. That will be where you can connect with us as a company, you can connect with tech support, and there will also be a host of resources found on that website that I will be referencing as we go through this training, which once again is a broad brush stroke, of additional videos and additional documents that will help you launch out in your endeavor and learn how to test with the OHD Quantifit. So super excited about our partnership and eager for you to connect with us with all your needs. Next thing we're going to cover today is what's all in the Quantifit case, so we can kind of familiarize you with what all you're looking at and what all you have. First things first is let's start with the primary, the Quantifit. You'll find the device in there. The beautiful thing about the Quantifit, it's very well labeled, and everything that we're going to talk about here shortly of the components, you'll easily be able to find where they attach to the instrument and how to operate the instrument. There is a quick start guide that you will be able to use that has everything written and some still photo images that will also help you figure out where to, you know, connect everything and how the device works. And we're going to talk about that quick start guide more in just 1 second. So there's the Quantifit. What next? I would say the next thing that we'd be eager to talk about, which is kind of pivotal, is your triple tube assembly. These tubes are going to be used to connect the device to the respirator. They're also going to be pivotal when we do our daily calibration. Next, we have our trigger button. The trigger button is the mechanism that you'll use to actually activate the device when you're wanting to challenge and test a respirator. The triple tubes and the trigger button are both going to connect to the device on the front of the instrument where it's clearly labeled they will go. Next, we're going to have a power cable and a transformer box. Power cable, pretty simple, just going from the outlet to the transformer box. Transformer box is going to be what runs to the back of the Quantifit. Give you a quick little heads up on the transformer box. There's some stickers on the transformer box that are warnings, cautions, that when you plug this into the back of the Quantifit, it doesn't just plug into the Quantifit. It actually locks into the Quantifit, and if you'll investigate this transformer box, you'll see there's a little quick connect at the end. You have to utilize that quick connect to unplug the device, otherwise you can harm this quick connect by trying to force it to come out. So just a quick little caution there, if you unplug the Quantifit, make sure you utilize that quick connect. Then we've got a little USB to PC cable. It's going to be how you connect the Quantifit to a computer. And finally, we've got a USB device that is going to be connected to the front handle of your Quantifit. That's going to be a key resource. That is going to have the Quantifit software on it for you to download. It's going to have the training video for you to view and use. It is going to have the quick start guide that I've already referenced and will continue to reference. And it will have other documents and resources that OHD feels is pertinent for you as you launch out to do fit testing. So this will be a great resource for you to have as well. Okay, those should be the components. Oh, finally, there will be a keyboard in the bottom of the Quantifit, and that will be pivotal if you're ever going to do standalone testing, managing the device by itself. We'll talk a little bit more about that in this training video, but there's going to be more in-depth resources on our website regarding standalone testing. Today's primary focus will be managing the device with the software. We're going to talk more about that in 1 second. Now, what we want to do is we want to talk about how to do a daily calibration to the device. Now, this is where you're going to want to heavily rely on the Quick Start Guide, because the Quick Start Guide has a written step-by-step process on how to daily cal the Quantifit. There will also be additional resources on our website that you can find to get assistance with that. Or you can call OHD's tech support if you need to. But just for a brief description of how we do a daily calibration. When you turn the device on, if it's the first time it's been turned on for that day, it will recognize that it is requiring a daily cal. You don't have to test it every, or calibrate it every day. You only calibrate it on days of testing. It's very simple. You'll just follow the instructions that are provided for you on the screen on the front of the Quantifit. But what the calibration basically entails is hooking up your triple tube assembly to the flow and pressure on the front of the instrument. You would leave your trigger button and your valve tube off of the front of the instrument during the daily cal. And it involves taking the two clear tubes and running them to the back of the instrument. And if you look at the back of your Quantifit right now, you'll see two posts that are labeled dual tube cal ports. And what you're going to take is you're going to take your clear tubes and you're going to connect them to those ports on the back of the Quantifit. Doesn't matter which one goes where, as long as the two clear tubes are side by side, they're fine. They don't have to specifically be on one port. Engaging the calibration consists of three clicks to this knob on the front of the Quantifit. You're going to say first that you want to perform the cal. It's then going to ask you to zero out the pump. You'll hit proceed. And if your tubes are in place, it's then going to ask you to proceed with the calibration, and you'll just hit proceed. The calibration roughly takes a minute, and that will be your daily calibration. For our purposes today with the quick start video, that's the description that we're gonna go with on the calibration. But once again, more resources available on the quick start guide and the website. Now we're gonna transition to the path splits at this point, and there's two ways that you can test with the Quantifit. You can either manage the device standalone, or you can manage the device via the FitTrack Gold OHD software. We at OHD highly recommend using the software as the primary function of using our technology, managing our technology. We feel that the software enhances the testing experience for the operator and the test subject, and that is going to be our primary focus on this video. If you want to do standalone testing, it's extremely easy, and the instrument does a phenomenal job of doing a standalone test. You'll just check our website for additional resources on how to do that, or you can reach out to OHD's tech support and they'll be eager to help. But for today, we're going to make the transition of walking through the software and showing you how to do a test on the software. Now let's focus in on the OHD FitTrack Gold software. Now, the focus of this video will just be to give you a quick start version of our software. There will be additional support and resources on our website and from OHD's tech support to get into the nitty-gritty details of the entire software and all of its features and functions. Today, my focus is primarily going to be on introducing you to the homepage, the dashboard of your fit testing program, how to get a test started up, how to administer a test, and how to manage your test results afterwards. Okay? Starting with the homepage and the dashboard. The homepage is meant to act as a dashboard for your fit testing program. There's a testing section, there's a section that keeps track of who's due for a test, some important links, There's a section for a keeping up with your mask inventory and the annual calibration of the Quantifit, just giving you the pertinent key details to the Quantifit system. The main focus of the software is going to be the testing section at the top center. Managing the 6 drop-down menus in that section is really the foundation to having a strong understanding of the OHD software. Having an understanding of selecting the proper company, operator, test subject, mask, size, and protocol, and how to even populate those drop-down menus is really the key to having a good, strong comfort with our software. So let's focus on that, and let's start with protocols. When you download the OHD FitTrack Gold software, protocols come pre-programmed. There's a number of protocols there. The focus for today is going to be the redon protocol, which is the protocol that is written into the OSHA standard and is OSHA compliant testing for all respirators with an elastomeric or rubber seal, whether it's a half mask or a full face respirator. Now, if you have questions about the other protocols that are listed there, or if you're testing masks with an elevated level of protection like an SCBA or CBRN, please reach out to OHD's tech support to learn more about those best practice protocols that are available. Now let's move to size. On size, the sizes come pre-programmed and you simply choose what size respirator is it, small, medium, large, extra large, etc. Let's move to mask. When you download your software and you drop down that mask menu for the first time, there will be no mask listed as OHD does not pre-program any respirators into the FitTrack Gold software. You will see one option when you drop that menu down. There's a place where you can add, new, or edit a respirator. You would simply select that option. It'll bring up a page where you can add, edit, delete, and manage respirators. You will have an empty bin there because you haven't yet added a respirator, and you'll simply click the add button. It'll give you a spot where you can list the make, model of the respirator, and choose whether it's a half mask or a full face respirator, and you would hit save after you included the needed information for the respirator you were looking to test. Once you add that respirator one time, it will be available in that drop-down menu moving forward. Let's move over to test subjects, operators, and companies. Very, very simple. To add a company, you look over to the toolbar on the left side of the screen. You'll see a company page. Go to that page, and in the top left corner, you will see a button that says add. You click that button, and that is where you can add a company. There are additional things that you can do with the company, and I would recommend that when you're adding a company, if you have questions about how that works and how to specifically require certain things for a company when you're adding test subjects, to just reach out to OHD's tech support. But pretty self-explanatory where you can add a company from there. All right, let's go down to the next drop down. Operator, how do we add an operator? Pretty simple. You're gonna look over at that toolbar on the left. You're gonna see an admin page. Go to the admin page. It's a little tricky. If you scroll to the bottom of the admin page, there's a place that says security, user management, add or edit user. Little tricky because it doesn't say add an operator. If you'll click that add or edit user button, that is where you can add your operators. And once again, once they're added there, when you go to the home page and you drop down the operator menu, they'll be there moving forward listed there. How do we add a test subject or personnel? Very simple. We're going to go to the personnel page. When you're on the personnel page, it's key that you identify what company is currently selected on the personnel page. If I was working for OHD, I would simply want to make sure that OHD was selected in the company's page. And when I hit add, I know I would be adding someone specifically to OHD. The add button, once again, is in the top left corner and you'll see it. So to add a person, it's very simple. Go to the personnel page, make sure the specific company that you want is selected, and then hit add, and it will allow you to add a test subject or an individual to the department or company desired. From there, you would simply go back to the home page and you've got your 6 drop-down menus populated with the company, operator, test subject, mask, sizes and protocols that you need, and you would simply hit that start test button. And that is going to bring you to a page where you're going to have big, bold instructions that are going to lead you through the testing process, and it will kind of step by step walk you through the test. And we're going to get more into the physical testing process in just 1 second, but I wanted to indicate to you how you would physically start a test at this point. The other things that I want to share with you in this quick start guide regarding the software for today would be how to manage data. How do we pull up the fit testing results that we've had? There's two primary ways you can look up your fit testing records or data. One, if you go to the personnel page, you will see on the toolbar up top, there's a button that says history. And if you're on the personnel page, you can select a company, select an individual, hit the history button, and it will give you the history of that individual at that company. Okay? You could print off specific tests for that individual, or you could print off that individual's entire fit test record or history with that company. The other way that you can manage your fit testing data is by going to our reports page. You will see when you go to the reports page, which is once again selected on that left hand toolbar, that there is a option at the very top of the screen to choose a host of different reports. I just want you to be familiar with where you can go to run reports on entire companies for the purpose of this video. When it is time for you to run a report on an entire company or department's fit test, we are super eager for you to reach out to OHD's tech support, because they will identify exactly what report from the different options that you have will best meet your needs, and they can even help you walk through filtering that report to make sure that you're getting the, you know, desired year, date, week, group, whatever. There's a lot of ways that you can filter the reports. So those are going to be our focuses for the software today. You now know the feel of the homepage. You're familiar with how to populate the 6 key drop-down menus, how to select what you need, get a test started up, and how to focus on pulling up the data, whether it be for an individual or for an entire company. And now I'm excited about transitioning and showing you a test in action. All right, we've arrived at the point of actually doing the OHD test. Now, before we jump into a test, I want to give a brief description of how the Quantifit challenges a respirator, the controlled negative pressure technology, and then we'll give a brief description of the testing process, but we'll really let you get a familiarity with the testing process as our test subject is going through the testing process, okay? So, controlled negative pressure, here's what we've got. The Quantifit, when connected to a respirator, test subject dons the mask. The Quantifit uses the controlled negative pressure to challenge the respirator to determine whether it's a good fit or not a good fit. How does controlled negative pressure work? Very, very simple. The Quantifit gently pulls the air out of the respirator while the test subject's wearing it. When we remove all the air out of this respirator and establish a negative pressure inside the mask, the air outside of this respirator is naturally going to do one thing, and that is penetrate this respirator to get into the negative pressure that's been established inside the mask. The thought process: if this is the right size respirator for me, if I don it properly, if there's no mask integrity issues, and if I have good face-to-seal contact, nothing impeding or obstructing face-to-seal contact, I should be able to pull a pressure, hold the pressure, and get very little leakage into the respirator. On the contrary, if it's the wrong size respirator for me, if I don it improperly, if there is a mask integrity issue, or if I do have something obstructing face-to-seal contact, the Quantifit will start to identify air penetrating the respirator for any and all of those reasons, and that will start to drive down your fit factor and could potentially even create a failing score. So the less air the Quantifit finds into the mask, the higher a fit factor. The more air a Quantifit finds, the lower a fit factor, okay? Now, it's gonna lead us through a 5-step testing process, which is called the redom protocol. Brief description of it up front for you. Test subject is gonna face forward on step 1. They're gonna face the floor on step 2. They're gonna shake their head and come to a stop on step 3. They're gonna remove the respirator and redon the respirator on step 4. and they're going to remove the respirator and redon the respirator on step 5. Each step, the Quantifit's going to pull a negative pressure, hold that pressure, and search for leakage. Each step is 8 seconds long. Each step, the test subject must hold their breath because the Quantifit is trying to establish a negative pressure inside the respirator. And to do that, the test subject must hold their breath. Now, I'm going to go ahead and get our test subject into the respirator, and I'm going to give you more information on this testing process as Luke goes through the test for us here, okay? All right, we're ready for a test. All right, first thing I want you to notice, and you'll notice this when you get the more in-depth training on your software, is you're going to have big, bold instructions on the software that are going to lead you through each step. So that's going to be the part that kind of leads you through it. On the first step, all we're going to want Luke to do is face forward, hold his breath, and he's going to press and hold the button that activates the instrument. Real quick tutelage on the button. Very simple. You press and hold it. The instrument will run for 8 seconds on its own. It will automatically stop when it's completed the step. You will hear it stop. It will tell you it stops, and it's going to quickly tell you if it passed or failed the step. So we'll hand that over to Luke, and he can go ahead and start on step 1. He does a breath in. He's holding his breath. He's facing forward. He's remaining completely still. The Quantifit's pulling the pressure on the respirator and looking to identify leakage. Okay? He gets a pass on that step. He gets to take as much time as he wants in between steps, but step number 2 is face the floor. He's going to face the floor. He presses and holds the button. He remains completely still, holds his breath. This step is the gravitational step. We're trying to see, now that he's facing the floor, will the gravitational pull on the respirator create leakage? He's now ready for step 3. He's going to shake his head, move it all about. He's going to come to a stop, draw his breath, press and hold the button. This is the reseat step. Will the mask reseat to the test subject's face after vigorous movement? Can it find its home? Now we're ready for step number 4. This is where the Quantifit's testing process becomes really unique. He's actually going to remove and redon the mask on step number 4. Thought process here is a bunch of research was done to respirators to determine why they leak. And one of the number one things they found was that test subjects don't don mask properly. So on step 4, he's removing the respirator, redonning it, drawing his breath, pressing and holding the button, and the Quantifit's going to pull that pressure and search for leakage. He's now on his 5th and final step, which is once again a remove and redon. There's a large eagerness on OHD's part to make sure that the test subject is familiar and has practiced while they're getting their fit test on how to don that mask properly. So he redonned it on step 5, faces forward, presses and holds the button, negative pressure, and it searches for leakage. And that is a completed OHD Quantifit fit test. Now we're going to transition to teach you how to troubleshoot a respirator when it doesn't look that good. All right, now that you've seen a Quantifit test in action, let's talk about how to troubleshoot a respirator that may not be passing the negative pressure test. There's a 5-step process to troubleshooting a mask. Now, before we dig into this 5-step process, this is another moment where I'm going to highly encourage you to not only access the troubleshooting document that we have that can be found on our website, but to really lean into your relationship with OHD's tech support, as they are ready and willing to assist with any fit test that you've encountered that you're finding it troublesome or difficult to get a passing result. We also will have a more in-depth video that will be more specific to troubleshooting a respirator. But for today, let's go over these 5 steps to troubleshooting a respirator. Step number 1 is you want to check the graph that will either be displayed on the Quantifit if you're doing standalone testing, or it will be displayed on the software if you're managing the device with the OHD software. This graph is very simple. You'll see a vertical axis where it calculates the pressure that the Quantifit will be creating in the respirator, and you'll see a horizontal axis where it will be calculating the time that the Quantifit is holding that pressure. On that graph, you'll see a red line. That red line notes the negative pressure the Quantifit wants to develop or establish in the respirator. When you activate a Quantifit test, you will see a line run up to that red line. That is the Quantifit gently pulling the air out of the respirator. And then you will see the Quantifit try to trace that red line, hold the pressure in that respirator, and while it's tracing that red line and holding the pressure, that is when the Quantifit is searching to see exactly how much leakage is penetrating the respirator. The first step to troubleshooting a respirator is to monitor that graph, because that graph can note a number of things. That graph can note if there's a major leak occurring to the respirator. That graph can note if there's a minor leak occurring in the respirator. That graph can note if the test subject is potentially breathing during the test, if the test subject is moving during the test. And that graph will give you an indication if the inhalation valve is prohibiting the Quantifit from doing the negative pressure test properly. Regarding that, the inhalation valve, there is another video that OHD is producing that will specifically talk about how to address an inhalation valve on a respirator when doing a negative pressure Quantifit test. But for today's point, when we focus on troubleshooting, step number one is you want to check that graph to see if the graph gives you any indication of why a failure is occurring. The second step to troubleshooting a respirator is to physically look at the respirator. We ask three questions of every mask we test. Question number one, is it donned properly? Question number two, is it the right size? Question number three, what is the condition of this respirator? Could there be a mask integrity issue that is creating a failure? So those are the three questions we ask of any respirator: donning, size, condition of the mask, and that's step number two of troubleshooting a respirator. Step number three of troubleshooting a respirator is where we focus on the test subject. There's a number of things we look at here. One, is the test subject holding their breath properly? Two, does the test subject have anything impeding good face-to-seal contact, whether it's a full face or a half mask? Things we're looking for there are bang hair, facial hair, and any other thing that could be impeding face-to-seal contact. The third thing that we're going to check on the test subject, and this is a little weird, but is their eardrums. If someone has blown or perforated eardrums, when you challenge the respirator with the Quantifit, it can, at times, pull air through their ears, through their sinuses, through their nose, into the respirator, and the Quantifit will fail them, thinking it's identifying leakage from outside the mask when it's really just pulling air through their head. It's very rare because we do not experience a lot of test subjects with blown or perforated eardrums, but we experience it enough to make mention of it while we troubleshoot a respirator. That is not the first thing I would check when troubleshooting a respirator. That is one of the last things I would check. But the things that we're looking for in a test subject: bang hair, facial hair, breathing, and then finally eardrums. The fourth part of troubleshooting a respirator, or the fourth step of troubleshooting a respirator, is when you look at your components. Your components are going to be the triple tube assembly that runs from the Quantifit to the respirator. It's going to be your adapter and possibly a connection piece. The adapter are going to be the blue high-grade aluminum adapters that you would get from OHD. The connection pieces are made by mask manufacturers such as MSA and Scott that use to connect to their respirators. Let's start with a focus on the triple tube assembly. The triple tube assemblies are very, very simple to use, and we rarely see anything occur with the triple tube assemblies that can affect a positive or negative fit test. One thing to keep an eye out, though, is where the quick connects go into the end of each tube. At times, those quick connects will wear those tubes at the end and maybe even put a little pinhole in the tubes at the end. Very simple fix, pull the quick connect out, find where the hole is, take a pair of scissors and trim that tube up to remove that hole, reinstall your quick connect, and you're back in business. Specifically to the OHD adapters, there's really only three things that you have to watch for on these adapters. One, primarily, is make sure they are installed onto the respirator properly. Whether it's a quarter turn, a screw in, or whatnot, you want to make sure that the adapter is seated and properly and firmly put onto the mast to where there is no leakage that can occur from the marry of the respirator to the adapter. The other things you want to look out for on these adapters is, if you will get a chance to look closely in some of our other videos, there are posts on these adapters where the tubes connect to these adapters. Those posts are all screwed in, which means they have the natural ability to back out and get loose. If those posts get loose, they can become a leak source, and that can affect your fit test. So you want to make sure, just by hand tightening these posts, that they're all secure. The third and final thing we see on the adapters, and this is very rare, is you will see there is an orange gasket on the heads of the adapters, and those gaskets can wear out and become a leak source. When you purchase a Quantifit, they supply additional gaskets for your adapters when they send them to you. It's very simple. If you ever needed to replace this gasket, you would just unscrew the head of the adapter, put the new gasket down, and hand tighten these screws back, and you'd be back in the business of testing. The third thing that you check when it comes to your components would be your mask manufactured connection pieces. We're not going to get into a lot to that today, because that is going to be independent to the different respirators that test subjects, or excuse me, companies would be testing with. Please reach out to OHD's tech support if you have any concern that the specific respirator you're testing with, especially if it includes a mask manufactured connection piece, please reach out to OHD's tech support to get any specific troubleshooting methods for those parts and components. The fifth step to troubleshooting a respirator is what we've talked about throughout this entire training. That is where you would lean into your relationship with OHD. You would reach out to our tech support that is eager to help, is accessible, and is knowledgeable, and they would help you address while the mask is not passing. So what this looks like is a failure occurs, we would recommend that you would go through this five-step process, you know, with the test subject primarily first, and if you weren't able to identify why the mask was not passing, you would quickly reach out to OHD's tech support and get the assistance that you need. So you're looking at, you would check the graph on the Quantifit, you would check the respirator, you would check the test subject, you would check your components, and then if needed, you would reach out to OHD's tech support. I'm very hopeful that today's training has served as a quick start guide for you in your endeavor as you launch out to do fit testing with the Quantifit. OHD is 100% committed to providing support for the life of the equipment, and we are eager to help. Best of luck to you with your fit testing, and we look forward to you reaching out with any and all things that we can assist with. Thank you.